Hi everybody, today is February 2nd, 2013. Syrian opposition chief meets Russia's Lavrov in Munich. Mosa Kadib, president of the Syrian National Coalition, says he received a clear invitation from the foreign ministry to visit Moscow. Al-Kadib also meant to meet with Joe Biden and Lakhdar Brahimi. The head of the Syrian opposition, Mozaz Al-Kabi, told Reuters he had met Russian foreign ministry on Saturday on the sideline of a conference in Munich and had been invited to Moscow. Syrian coalition officials said on Friday that Al-Kadib was sent to meet U.S. Vice President Joe Biden, Russian Foreign Minister Sergey Lavrov, United Nations Envoy Lakhdar Brahimi, at a conference on Saturday. And I bet you they're getting information about what Syria and Iran is saying about this research center that was bombed. On Saturday, a diplomatic source told Reuters that Al-Kadib will also meet Iranian Foreign Minister Ali Akbar Shali on the sidelines of the conference. The talk about Syria are intensifying and the Iranians have been drawn in. No, they drew themselves in. Let's see how it all ends, the source said. Iran is claiming that this research center that was supposedly bombed by Israel had over 3,000 Iranian troops posted there along with Russians. That's the latest rhetoric. After his meeting with Foreign Minister Sergey Lavrov, Al-Kadib, president of the Syrian National Coalition, said he received a clear invitation from the foreign ministry to visit Moscow, a breakthrough in relations that could help pave the way for a solution to the Syrian crisis. Russia has certain visions, but we welcome negotiations to alleviate the crisis, and there are a lot of details that need to be discussed, Al-Kadib said after the talks. Also on Saturday, Lavrov said that the Syrian chemical weapons are safe in the regime hands, and reiterated Moscow's support for Syrian President Bashar Assad's nearly two-year battle against opposition forces. They're now saying about 70,000 people have died in this two-year battle. The greatest danger is the possibility that the chemical weapons will fall into rebel hands, Lavrov said while attending the Munich Security Conference in Germany. While the weapons remain under government control, we are confident that there is no cause for serious concern, he said. Lavrov also cautioned that we should avoid a forceful intervention, especially without the mandate from the UN Security Council. Now you know Israel isn't going to do that. And spoke out against arbitrary sanctions on Damascus. On the sideline of the international conference, Lavrov met with U.S. Vice President Joe Biden on Saturday, described Assad as a tyrant and that he must go. Western powers have previously warned Assad that there would be an immediate reaction to any use of chemical weapons against the opposition, which have been fighting to oust the Syrian leader since March of 2011. The UN estimates more than 60,000 people have been killed in the fighting. What's been updated is now about 70,000. Inside Syria, rebels claim 40 people were killed across the country on Saturday, while activists said heavy clashes raged near a major military base in Meez, a key supply link for the regime forces in the capital. Rami Adel Rahman, head of the Syrian Observatory for Human Rights, told ADP rebels and troops were also clashing near the Damascus suburb of Daraa. Daraa is now under rebel control, but Syrian forces have reportedly brought in tanks in an effort to reclaim it. News from Syria cannot be verified, that's why there's so many rumors going around, because most journalists are still banned from entering restrictive areas across the country. Because of that, I'm sure this whole fiasco with that research center, they're questioning the opposition, because the opposition originally was claiming that they had fired two rockets at the facility. All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.